Oh, hi, Amy. How are you doing today?
I'm well, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. Well, thanks for the opportunity to have this, to be able to talk to you today. I'm so excited because I'm such a big fan and I'm such a big fan of the show. So
Oh, good.
congratulations,
Thank you.
fourth season. Are you guys like still kind of, like, can you believe that how it's been accepted and how everybody feels about this amazing show?
No. I can't. I still, it's so funny. Every season, I'll see a billboard or I'll see the credits, and I can't, first of all, I can't believe I'm in there. Like, I'm like, what am I doing there? And then I can't believe we're getting to stay together as a family. I mean, it's sort of like to have the best job you've ever had in your life and to get to continue to do it as an actor is unheard of. And I'm so. I love that I do work that feels not like it just feeds my narcissistic actor ego, but actually sort of helps change the world. It's a profound, very. I feel very, very blessed. It's been, and we just got picked up for season five.
I know.
I can't believe it. I still can't believe
Well,
it.
no, it is amazing. And as you say, it is a show that does pretty much change the world. And it's so, if anything, it's more relevant today
Yeah.
than ever.
Yeah, it's interesting because we came. This is actually the first year that we weren't invited to the White House, and I just realized why this morning. I was like, "Oh yeah, we're in a very different time," and it's a part of the conversation, the national conversation, and I think that it's great that we can tell sort of an everyday story of a trans person that is basically just about a person in a family, and the transness of that character is not what the show is about, or it's just part of the reality of this family. And I think, that there's something very significant about having access to those stories. It's how a lot of things have changed throughout history in different civil rights movements as we've kind of gotten to know people and normalized things that maybe were not didn't feel normal before. And so I feel like it's a wonderful show right now to sort of keep the conversation going and communication open about what this experience is,
Absolutely. Now, last season, I mean, your character went through quite a bit. There was a lot of intense stuff going on. I'm not going to get too into it. But for the coming season, I understand that you got to go to Israel, and I'm really excited for you, and I'm really excited to see that. What was that experience like for you?
It was amazing. I mean, I have to admit that, and I know it feels I hate even admitting this, but we actually the actors ourselves did not actually go to Israel.
Oh, boo! I thought you did get to go.
I
Okay,
know,
well, that
I
sucks.
know.
Anyway.
And I feel like I just want to lie and say we did,
All
but I
right.
can't.
Yeah, okay.
But what was kind of amazing is the way that we recreated it here in Los Angeles. We did actually go into the middle of the desert, and we had like a Bedouin camp with camels, and we spent a couple of days in water doing the Dead Sea. We actually created a wailing wall at Paramount that we had a ceremony with a rabbi before. I mean, we took it so deeply seriously, and the production design was so incredible that we sort of felt like we were transported somewhere else. I will say too, Sarah's year is much lighter, and I had a really fun. I go on. I bring my husband or ex-husband or whatever he is, Len, on the trip, and have kind of just it's a very different year for her. It was a really fun experience, and but yeah, there's a lot of logistical, political, a lot of stuff going on in terms of us all going as a group. So we just sent the crew and the writers and the director, and they did a lot of movie magic.
Good stuff. Well, I still look forward to that. That'll be a really great opportunity to see that. Now, I have to tell you something because I'm pretty obsessed with watching that show, Room 104. So, yes, so I watched it this week, and look who was on there. You.
Yes.
Oh my God, that show is the craziest thing, but I am so obsessed with it. How did you enjoy
It was
doing
amazing.
that show and then working with the Duplass brothers, too?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's funny. The truth about that is that Toni Collette, who's one of my favorite actors, was that was her episode, and she unfortunately got the flu like a day before. So I stepped into that with absolutely no like preparation, which is always the best way, I think, to do anything because you can't think about it and you just had to jump in. I knew the concept. And of course, Jay and his brother Mark, whatever they do, I would say yes. I think they're just brilliant. I mean, obviously, Jay plays my brother on the show, so it's always fun to work with him as a writer, director, and producer. And it was really, and I also was working with Mae Whitman, who's on Arrested Development, which is funny because I also have Alia Shawkat with me this year on Transparent, who's from Arrested Development. So Mae was amazing, and it's been an episode a lot of people have asked me. I mean, I think it's one of those Twilight Zone, what's actually happening. And I always tell people the fly in the room is the clue as to what's actually going on, that there's a fly. Why is there a fly?
Yes.
Perhaps there's some decay.
It's so cool. Yeah. It is such a cool, very clever show. Very quickly, too, I want to ask you about a movie that you have coming up, because you just have so much stuff. I don't know how you even sleep, get time to sleep. But you've got a film coming up with Jim Parsons and Claire Danes.
Yeah.
It's called A Kid Like Jake. And it's interesting because it deals with a four-year-old who's dealing with, what is it, like gender identity. So it's kind of interesting how it kind of ties into Transparent a bit. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Well, it was really because of Transparent that I got that part, because Silas Howard, who is a director of our show, directed that film. And Silas is trans, a trans male. He also directed an episode of This Is Us. He's sort of probably making history. I can't remember another, trans male working on network television as a director. And he's the perfect person to tell this story about this kid who, it's not that the kid is trans, we don't really know, the kid's four.
But
just sort of dealing with, gender identity and how the family deals with that. And it was so amazing. I'm a huge fan of Jim and Claire Danes, and and it was just a beautiful experience. It was, Silas is an incredible director, and I was honored that he thought of me. And I think it's going to be a really touching, funny, I think Viola Davis is, I mean, the cast is incredible.
Really good cast.
So I think it's going to be, and I know the little boy actually is having that experience. And I always feel like when you find, we also had a little trans girl on Transparent, when you have kids who are actors who are really relating to the storyline, there's something very magical about it. It feels very pure and honest, and I think it's going to be a great film.
Well, good luck with that. And I'd, like I say, such a huge fan of Transparent.
Thanks.
And can't wait to see, I know all the fans are chomping at the bit for season four, and now we know with season five. So that's all amazing. So just give all the Pfeffermans a big hug for me. And thanks for your time today, Amy. Really, really
appreciate
it. Thanks,
Bonnie. It's nice talking to you.